Hello students, welcome to an academy. I'm Krishna Verma, your educator, and in this lesson I will explain the comparison of spark ignition engine and compression ignition engine on the basis of different variable. Which engine is superior in terms of working and efficiency on the basis of different variable, I will explain in this lecture. So let's start our lesson, that is comparison of spark ignition and compression ignition engine. These are the contents of today's lesson. I will discuss the comparison of spark ignition engine and compression ignition engine on the basis of different variables. This diagram is representing the working of a spark ignition engine and this representing the working of compression ignition engine. Here, first difference is we are using here spark plug for the ignition, but we are using the during this compression ignition, this fuel will ignite because of high temperature and high pressure of air, or we will consider self ignition of the fuel here. And let's discuss the comparison of spark ignition engine and compression ignition engine on the basis of different variables. So in this category, the first variable is thermodynamic cycle. So the spark ignition engine is generally based on Otto cycle, but as we know, the CI engine is based on the diesel cycle or dual diesel cycle. See, on the basis of efficiency, we can say the diesel engine has high thermal efficiency than spark ignition engine. Second point is the combustion process. So it is spark ignition engine, so we can say it is spark ignition, the combustion only because of spark generated by the spark plug. But in compression ignition, it is we will consider the compression ignition or the compression the working, the air compressed by the piston, and the high pressure and high temperature air is responsible for the ignition, where here we considered auto ignition or self ignition for the combustion. Next point, or we can say in this particular point during the self ignition temperature, the speed and load controlled by the quantity of fuel. But in compression ignition engine, the speed is always regulated by the fuel injector. Here the supply of air is constant in case of increase in load and speed. The speed is only regulated by the fuel, but here this speed is regulated by overall mixture of the fuel. Next point is the compression ratio. So in a spark ignition engine, the compression ratio is lower compared to compression ignition engine, and because of this, the thermal efficiency of the diesel engine is always higher. Next point is the initial pressure. In this variable, we can say because of higher compression ratio, here if we consider higher compression ratio, so the operating pressure in the CI engine is always higher than the SI engine. So here the operating pressure in SI engine will be lower compared to CI engine, or we can also say the CI engine is heavily built, so the pressure will be higher because of this. Because of heavy construction, or because of the construction of CI engine, the pressure will always be higher in CI engine. Next point is the initial speed. See, the operating speed and the piston speed both are higher in spark ignition engine compared to compression ignition engine, because if we consider the same horsepower for the both engine, so the size of the spark ignition engine is always small. So as per the size, we can say according to the size of the engine, we are getting more power, so the initial speed will be higher in spark ignition engine. Next point is the distribution of fuel. See, distribution of fuel, if we are considering multi-cylinder engine, so in multi-cylinder engine, the distribution of fuel in a compression ignition engine is always proper, or we can say excellent in compression ignition engine. But in a spark ignition engine, the distribution of fuel is not proper. So this distribution of fuel causes increase in efficiency in compression ignition engine, because we are getting excellent distribution of fuel in case of multi-cylinder engine. Next point is supercharging. See, generally the compression ignition engine are more suitable for the supercharging compared to spark ignition engine. Spark ignition engine are less suitable for the supercharging, because the spark ignition engine, in spark ignition engine, the supercharging is limited by the detonation. That's why this compression ignition engine are more suitable for supercharging. Next point is exhaust gas temperature. So the exhaust gas temperature in compression ignition engine is low as compared to spark ignition engine, because the efficiency of compression ignition engine is higher, or we can say the high amount of heat we generally get in SI engine from the exhaust valve because of the low efficiency, and because of the higher efficiency of compression ignition engine, we get less amount of heat from the exhaust valve. So exhaust gas temperature is always considered low in compression ignition engine. Next point is the starting. So in terms of starting, generally in SI engine, we generally consider the starting easy compared to compression ignition engine. The starting is generally difficult in compression ignition engine because of low cranking effect. We consider the spark ignition engine is easy because of low cranking effect, and especially during the cold weather, the starting is difficult in compression ignition engine because the temperature of the air is low during the cold weather. So we consider the difficult starting during the cold weather in compression ignition engine. Next point is weight. So in SI engine, we consider the weight of the SI engine is low compared to CI engine. We consider the weight of the CI engine is heavy for this same power output. If we are considering same power output and as per the construction, the weight of the CI engine is heavy compared to SI engine, and generally the weight of the SI engine we consider the 0.5 to 4.5 kg per kilowatt for the same power output, but for CI engine we consider 3.3 to 13.3 kg per kilowatt hour. Next point is the power output per unit weight. So in compression ignition engine, we generally consider the power output per unit weight is low. We consider high power output in SI engine compared to compression ignition engine because in compression ignition engine, we get higher compression ratio and heavy weight. Next point is acceleration. So acceleration is good in a compression ignition engine because of direct control of quantity, or we can consider the quantity of fuel is better controlled by the fuel injection or the fuel injector in compression ignition engine. But in spark ignition engine, the fuel control is not good because it is because of throttling. So we can say the acceleration is not good compared to compression ignition engine. Next point is the air fuel ratio. So this is the limit of air fuel ratio for the spark ignition engine, but compression ignition engine we consider the air fuel ratio is between 17 to 100. Now next point is the specific fuel consumption. So if we are considering spark ignition engine, so the specific fuel consumption is low at full load but worse at part load in spark ignition engine. But in compression ignition engine, we consider the specific fuel consumption is better in we can say it is better at part load compared to full load in compression ignition engine. But if we compare with spark ignition engine, so CI engine is better in terms of specific fuel consumption. Next point is the cost of fuel. So we can say the fuel of the spark ignition engine, or we can say we are using petrol, so this is quite costly compared to compression ignition engine, because in CI engine the fuel has low density and high calorific value, so it is costly. But in compression ignition engine, it has in the compression ignition engine fuel or diesel fuel, we can say it has high density and low calorific value. Next point is the initial cost. So this spark ignition engine is less costly compared to compression ignition engine because of the lighter in construction. This SI engine is lighter in construction compared to CI engine. Now next is the maintenance cost. So we can say the CI engine, the maintenance cost for the CI engine is higher compared to spark ignition engine, because in CI engine the replacement of part is very costly and the repair charges or the maintenance charges for the compression ignition engine are also higher in CI engine. Next point is odor and smoke. So in terms of odor and smoke, we can say this SI engine is less objectionable compared to CI engine. Next point is combustion problem. So in combustion problem, as I discussed earlier in earlier lecture, we get knocking in SI engine, and this knocking is only because of the unburnt combustion. But in CI engine, we consider the diesel knock, and this diesel knock is only because of variations in different variable. We consider ignition delay, high C10 number and the self ignition temperature is responsible for the diesel knock. Next point is the fuel supply. So the fuel supply is generally in a spark ignition engine we use for fuel supply is carburetor, and this is the cheaper method or the cheaper way for the fuel supply. But in compression ignition engine, the fuel supply is quite costly because fuel injector is costly compared to carburetor. Next point is power. So we are getting less power in spark ignition engine compared to compression ignition engine. We get high power in compression ignition engine. Now last point is application. So this spark ignition engine is generally used in passenger cars or small vehicles like scooters, motorcycle, etc., because it is simple and it is light in weight and cheaper. But in compression ignition engines are generally used for the heavy vehicles like bus, trucks, locomotive, etc., because this CI engine has low running cost, and the CI engine we used for the long run. So we can say this SI engine used for small vehicle, but the CI engine is used for the heavy vehicle because of low running cost. So this was all about the comparison of SI engine and CI engine on the basis of different variables. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe the channel for more lectures.